strong revenue growth, EBITDA numbers much higher as well. Let's talk about all of that and more with the management of the company to talk about the quarter and, of course, the outlook ahead as well. Mr. B.L. Agrawal, he's the managing director, joins us right now on the show. Thanks so much, Mr. Agrawal, for joining in today. It was a robust quarter. Is this a sign of things to come? You believe this revenue growth numbers that you've shown, arguably also because maybe of lower basis, could continue into 2018?
Yeah, I'm sure next 3-4 quarters are going to be quite robust. Mm-hmm. And fortunately, we have the backward integration of our iron ore mines. Mm-hmm. And the prices of iron ore are going up. But our, because of captive mines, our prices are not impacting. Mm. That's the reason the company is doing, among all other players, is one of the, I think, better positioned. And pellet is our main business. Domestically also, and the export also is very robust, very, very robust. Mm. With the mining activities cutting down by almost 20 million ton in the state of Odisha because of Supreme Court order, there is a shortage of iron ore mine. And that's the reason the price of iron is also going up. And accordingly, the price of steel also, the price of pellet also. And I think this show will go on for quite some time. I believe that the metal cycle, which was earlier passing through the very, very bad phase, almost 3 to 4 years, I think will now pass through a good phase for again 3 to 4 years.
3 to 4 years. We've had a bit of a rally over the last 18 months, Mr. Agrawal, in the metal space as well. You are saying that your estimates or your assumption is, or your thoughts are that this will last for another 18 months at least, if not more?
Minimum.
Minimum 18
months. Minimum.
Okay. And now, what does this do to demand and final product prices? We'll come to the cost-effective measures in a bit. Firstly, about your product prices and the demand that is thereof. How does that look like for calendar year 18? And what would be capacity utilization levels that you would be at? Would you need, or are you looking to even expand capacities looking at this great cycle?
No, in fact, we do not want to expand our capacities, but we will integrate our capacities.
Okay.
Currently, we are producing about 4.5 lakh tons of sponge iron, but still we are able to produce only 2.5 lakh tons. And because we have some shortage of power, so we are eyeing on one asset which can be converted into our captive, then we will be able to a complete player from right from iron ore mining till our final product, which is wire rod. The other product is pellet. We have 2 iron ore mines. Total combined capacity is 2.1 million ton. The pellet capacity is again 2.1 million ton at Chhattisgarh and 0.6 million ton at Odisha. Almost 70% is captive. We have to buy only 30% from the open market. Now, because of shortage of the iron ore, the prices are going up. Accordingly, the pellet prices are also going up. Steel prices are also going up. And there is no sign of improvement in the mining capacities in the country. Just in the last week number of the import of the iron ore, earlier which was pegged to hardly 0.5 million ton a month, now January month it is expected that the import will cross about 1 million ton. It's very obvious sign because of iron ore, which is our backbone, our earnings, our growth will continue to do the similar position in the next quarter also, which we have already achieved from Q2 to Q3. I'm sure that we will achieve the same numbers again from Q3 to Q4.
Now by same numbers, okay, let me just refresh it for our viewers. Your revenues grew up to about 675 odd crores in quarter two. What's the annual guidance that you, quarter three, excuse me, what's the annual guidance that you believe could be there on your revenue front?
For FY19?
FY18, sir.
For FY18?
Yes.
Total revenue will be approximately 2,200. And I hope with the current run rate, I hope the EBITDA will be again plus 600.
Plus 600. Okay. Are you factoring in a jump in your EBITDA margins from where they are currently? Because your EBITDA performance was very strong and you spoke extensively right now about how because of what's happening in the state of Orissa and because you are integrated but others are not, your costs are much lower. With the uptick in revenues, would your operating margins improve further?
If we, because the realization in the Q3 was much lower as compared to the realization which we are fetching in Q4. Assuming our cost of production remains to be the same, even though the margins are on improving trend, so I think the EBITDA growth for the Q4 will be better than the EBITDA growth in Q3.
And EBITDA margins too will be better than Q3.
Yes.
So you've done 25%, they could be better than Q3.
Yes.
Okay. I have two last questions, sir, very quickly. Firstly, on debt. Now, your half-year debt, as Nikki, my analyst, tells me, was about 2,600 crores, if I'm not wrong.
No. My consolidated debt is 1,950.
1,950. Okay. Is there, as of end of Q3, okay, are there plans to bring it down further?
Definitely.
Okay.
By March, we'll bring it down by 100 crores.
Uh-huh.
But in the next 2 years, we are sure that we'll bring it down by additional 600 crores minimum.
Minimum 600 crores over the next 2 years. Okay.
Yeah.
And would you use this upcycle? It's prudent probably to do that, but would you use this upcycle and the markets are rewarding your stock performance as well to maybe raise some money for further expansion or to level out your debt equity ratios? Any plans of a QIP or any kind of additional equity fundraising?
In fact, we have in the last board meeting itself, we had taken a resolution to raise about 500 crores.
Via equities?
Via various means, FCCB, maybe the QIP and other means. Definitely, this is valid for 1 year. We'll go to the market at the appropriate time. And once we get these funds, so surely we'll use this fund mainly for the debt repayment.
So when will you do this fundraising by?
We have 1 year cushion.
Are you looking in the second half or the first half?
No. Maybe in the first half itself.
First quarter or?
Yes.
This current quarter, you're saying?
No, not the current quarter, but
first quarter of
FY19.
Okay, fair. You comfortable with the current valuations?
Yes.
For the QIP?
Yes, we are comfortable.
Okay, great. Good having you, Mr.
One thing I would like to add.
Yes, please.
Currently, promoters holding is about 67%.
Mm-hmm.
In no case, we will dilute beyond 55%.
Okay, fair call. Appreciate that candidness and thank you so much for taking the time out and joining us today, Mr. Agarwal. Good having you.